Hey, what is going on YouTube? In today's video, we are going right back into Home Assistant. And in this video, we're going to talk about the installation and configuration process for our sensors that we had just purchased. This is an AQARA sensor, AQARA, and it is for doors and windows. In this video, we're going to talk about Zigbee Home Automation configuration and also Zigbee2mqtt. The first automation or the first configuration is very simple. You could do it within just a few minutes, whereas the Zigbee2mqtt is also very simple, but it does require an additional configuration. And I definitely suggest you stay around for that, because a lot of the guidance that is out there today is not current or relevant to the information or the tools that you have. So with that being said, we're gonna get right into this video. Before I get started, I also wanna mention that down in the description below, it's gonna be two links to all of these products, one being the sensor and one being the dongle. The dongle is what you're gonna use in order to connect to the sensors, and that's gonna be through Zigbee. All right, so the prerequisite for this process, at the very minimum, you're going to need a Raspberry Pi. It is suggested to get a Raspberry Pi 4 or newer, so Raspberry Pi 5. The 3, you can do it, but apparently it is very slow. I did not test it. Maybe that is something that I could do in the future. But get Raspberry Pi 4 installed, or Raspberry Pi 4, and get Home Assistant installed onto it. That's not something I'm covering today. You can find that documentation. It's pretty straightforward. I also covered it recently as far as installing it on a different platform, but it's kind of the same process, but with Raspberry Pi, just a little bit different. Like I said, so we're going to go right into the first installation, and that's going to be for the Zigbee Home Automation. It's fairly straightforward, and all you're going to do is go down to Settings, go to Devices and Services, click on Integration tab. By default, when you first plug it in, you should actually see it up here. You also get a notification up here, but if you do not see it, go down to Add Integration down here at the bottom right. Click on Add Zigbee Device. It's going to say to add a Zigbee device, you first need a supported hardware and the Zigbee integration setup. And just go ahead and click Proceed. Once you have that, you should be able to, if you have the USB, you should have it connected already at this point. You're going to just go ahead and select that here, hit Submit. All right, so since I had done this before, we're going to have a little bit more options available to me. You're not going to have these options, but I'm going to go ahead and just click on erase network settings and create a new network. I'll have a similar option as saying create a new network if you have not done this before. All right, it is a success. Go ahead. Down here, you're going to find a similar reference here, magnet AQ2. Go ahead, click an area. In this case, I have an area set up for office, and click finish. So now at this point, you're going to want to click on the one entity option here. You might see something different there depending on what you have done previously. Go ahead to the bottom right, click on add device. And on the sensor that you have purchased, again, it is in the description below. If you get the same one that I have, it's pretty straightforward. You're going to click the little button on the very top, depending on how you're looking on it, until it flashes blue. Once you flash blue, like I had just done, you will get a little green notification saying that the initialization has been completed. And then you're going to go ahead and say the device is ready to use. So at this point, you don't really have to do anything. Go ahead, select the area and what that applies to. Go back. And now you can see we have the various sensors and entity IDs and the different things that we can do with that sensor. So in this case, we have the open right here. And that's going to be able to tell us if this is open or closed. As you can see, I had just closed the sensor. So that means I had touched the two together, which is pretty much a magnet. And it's able to identify whether that magnet is touching the sensor. And then once we pull it apart, we have open. And there's a lot of things that we can do with that. But for this video, that pretty much gives you the installation and configuration process of setting up Zigbee Home Automation. And now for the next one, which is more complicated and is also suggested, this Zigbee Home Automation is pretty closed down and it's locked down to certain devices. Now with Zigbee2mqtt, it opens up a new world of devices, a whole lot more that you can do with it. So that's what we're going to go into next. Before going into the next installation process, the Zigbee2mqtt, we're going to have to disable the Zigbee Home Automation. So go back into Settings, and you're going to go into Devices and Services, and then you're just going to right click on, or you're going to click on it as if it was here. I had already removed it, but if you were to click on MQTT, it's going to be the same process. Go into the three dots and then click on Delete. Do that for the Zigbee Home Automation, the one we had just set up. And once that is complete, then you can proceed with the next step. All right, so next, you're going to go over to Settings, click on Add-ons, and then at the bottom right, you're going to click on Add-on Store. Then we're going to search for Mosquito Broker. Go ahead and install that now. While that's loading, you're going to want to go over to the settings, or go back into the settings, click on people, and then you're going to want to go ahead and create a user. So go to users, and then you can do add user down here. And what we have set up here is just an MQTT underscore user, and we had defined a password. Here's the settings here. We can't see the password. Just did MQTT underscore password, !! And that's just for the lab. So go ahead and do that now. These are the settings that you want, and you're going to need that to continue on. So go back to settings, go back to add-ons. Mosquito Broker is finished. We're going to want to turn on Watchdog. Once Watchdog is turned on, click on Start. All right, next we're going to go to Settings, Devices and Services. Then you're going to see MQTT. Go ahead and click on Configure, Reconfigure MQTT. And this is where you're going to define the username and password. You could go ahead and keep the broker default, the port default, and then go ahead and change it here. The username is going to be something else, so go ahead and enter that information here and click on Next, and it's failed to connect. All right, once I can type it right after the third time, you'll be able to get to the next screen, different options that are available to you. You can leave that all default. Click on Submit. All right, success, options successfully saved, and click on Finish. So now we have installed MQTT broker, and we had added and configured our user that we had just created within that broker. Next, you're going to want to go ahead and set up the repository. To do that, go to Settings, go to Add-ons, and you're going to want to click on Add-on Store. Over here at the top right, you're going to click on Repositories, and then you're going to want to add this repository here, and I will add that in the description below. And that will give you access to Zigbee2mqtt, which is right here. Make sure you don't click on the edge or the proxy. You will need the first option. So now we're going to click on Install. Once this is installed, we're pretty much done at this point. Is the only point, next thing that we got to do is set up the configuration. So while this is installing, all right, we're going to set up Watchdog again, and we're going to do show on sidebar. Before we go ahead and start this and go into the configuration, go back into settings, go into system, go into hardware, all hardware, and then you're going to just want to search TTY. And then bring this down, and then you're going to want to copy this. Go ahead and copy that information down. Go back into settings. Let's go back into add-ons, Zigbee2mqtt, and go into configuration. And here, the only thing that we're going to add is the following. So we're just going to do port, space, and then we're going to type in that information we had just copied. Go enter. And then the next thing that you want to do, this is where a lot of the internet has failed me, is you want to do adapter. There's many adapters. There's Ember. There's, I think that's like ZHC or something like that, or ZHS. But in this case, we want to do ZStack. Now, I don't know what's going to work for you, but I could promise you, well, I could tell you with good confidence that if you get the same devices that are listed down in the description below, you should be able to get this set up just fine by using ZStack. Otherwise, I was trying a million different things and I could never get it to work. I was getting plenty of errors. I couldn't figure out why. So go ahead, click Save. Now, once you hit Save, this is another thing that I noticed. It just pushes it down the next line. I'm assuming there's just a limited amount of space here, so it just kind of ends it on the next line. So go ahead, back to Info tab, and then we're going to click on Start. Once we're in Start, go to Log. As you noticed, there were some failures, or maybe I didn't show it at that time, but I just realized that I had placed it in the wrong section. So instead of placing MQTT, you're going to go ahead, copy that from here, and paste it down into the serial section. Once you have done that, you're going to go ahead and click on Save. Go back into Info, click on Start, go back into Log, and then we should see it starting just fine. Now, if you go into the Zigbee2mqtt over here on the left, we're going to go ahead and hopefully delete this, as this was from before. All right, so once that's removed, all you're going to do here at the top is you're going to click on Permit Join All. Once you click on that, you're going to do the same thing we had mentioned before. Go ahead and click on that little button on the top of the sensor until it flashes blue. Once it's flashing blue, that means it is in pairing mode. Give it a second. There you go. Pops right up. It's going to do its little process of interviewing the device, and it's going to say successfully configured that device. Go ahead, click on that friendly name. Click on State, and as you can see, we have contact true and false, and that is me adding or touching, and this is me removing it. Door is open, door is closed. And that's going to close out today's video. So in this video, we talked about two different installation processes or two different Zigbee configurations. The first being Zigbee Home Automation, and then the second being Zigbee2mqtt, the latter being more preferred within the home automation group, mostly because it has more devices and sensors available to it. But like I said, all of this information is in the description below. So I'm going to provide those two sensors along with the USB dongle in the description below. Go ahead and definitely order those exact devices to follow this tutorial. The reason why I say that is because, yes, you could get away with the Zigbee Home Automation. It's a lot easier, but for whatever reason, I could not find relevant or good quality information in terms of the Zigbee2mqtt tutorial, and that is what I provided you today. So I hope you were able to take something away, and as always, never stop learning.